Okay, so I know I've not done a video in a while. I've been quite busy with everything. Not had a lot of free time. But in some of the free time that I have had, I've been messing around with this, which you might recognise from previous videos. Basically, it's an 8x8 audio video matrix. It means I can patch any input to any output. I use it to connect the audio systems in my house. It's on the back there, somewhere, just there, has a serial port, which I've got connected to my Raspberry Pi there via the GPIO, which I've got running Python. So I have been writing all of this code. Over the past like ages, basically just doing an hour here or there when I actually have the time. This is pretty much my first project ever, writing proper code. It is in Python, but good enough. Basically, the stage I've got to now is that Raspberry Pi also is running MySQL. So here on the laptop, you can see we're connected to the MySQL database. We've got two tables here, audio outputs and video outputs. In each one you've got 8 rows, which corresponds to one of the outputs here. So you've got output, so output 1, 2, 3, all the way to 8, and then input. So you can see there, input 5, 2, 2, 2, 2, 3, 2, 2. It's the same as here, 5, 2, 2, 2, 2, 3, 2, 2. So if I just change this now, say output, that'll do, so you can see that's jumbled up compared to there. And then if I just refresh the program, you can see successfully updated SQL audio and video. Also, it tells you the status there. So if we then refresh this SQL page, shame it's not in focus, you can see it's updated there with the new values. Now, I've still got to work on basically making this constantly update so that whenever I change something on here, it's changes it on here, and I've got to make it so that whenever this senses a change in this file, it updates that. Basically, the reason it's going through MySQL is because eventually, when I learn how to do it, I'm going to build a web interface in PHP, so I'll be able to not have to go anywhere near this and just be able to say I want room 3 to go to input 5 or something like that. And it'll change the SQL, which will in turn change that, which will change that. Any questions, please ask. Hope you've found this video informative or whatever. Cheers for watching. Bye.